MTN, everywhere you go. Keep walking.
Chers invités, bonsoir. Merci d'avoir laissé vos préoccupations habituelles et surtout d'honorer en ce soir notre rendez-vous. C'est dans l'humilité profonde que ma voix s'associe à celle du président du groupe Africa Search, M. Didier Akwete, qui a fait le déplacement spécialement ce soir pour vous souhaiter une chaleureuse bienvenue. The Swara Leadership is an event with the aim of unleashing the potential of leaders. It's a platform where young people can gather as well as exchange knowledge and expertise. Ce soir, nous avons le privilège de recevoir notre premier invité. Je profite également de cette occasion pour souligner le fait que nous aurons un événement comme celui-ci une fois par mois. Donc je veux dire merci à tous les mécènes, à tous les sponsors. Je dis merci à MTN, à Johnny Walker, à ici les gens du Cameroun, à Unknown Ad, et toutes les personnes qui, de loin ou de près, ont participé à l'avènement de cette première édition. It's a privilege and honor to me to welcome on this stage our first guest, someone that I have a great deal of respect, someone who has proven leadership quality and expertise. Ladies and gentlemen, with all your respect, I would like you to put your hands together for Mr. Cartoriola. Mr. Cartoriola will speak for 10 minutes and after that we'll take some few questions. You're welcome, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Bonsoir. I'm a bit intimidated to see this gathering of people because I honestly expected people fresh out of university, young faces, hungry for knowledge. And I see people here that know a lot more about leadership than I do. But I thought, all the same, let's have a discussion about leadership and let's see what we can ideas we can exchange with ourselves about this. I would like this to be an interactive session, and if you would wish, please ask me questions in French, and I'll struggle and answer. Let me start off by telling you a little bit about myself. I joined MTN Cameroon just on the 1st of December 2011, so I've been in Cameroon for almost seven months now. I come from humble beginnings. Both my parents were university professors in a university called University of Ife. In Nigeria, I'm an engineer by training. I'm African first, but also half Swiss. I've worked through various layers and parts of the industry, in the telecommunications industry, in Nigeria specifically, in Africa as a whole, and to some extent as well in Europe. I built the biggest network in the Middle East, Europe, and Africa region with MTN Nigeria, where I was chief technical officer for a total of 5 years. The network has 42 million subscribers. We spent capital expenditure of over $5 billion over 5 years. We laid over 12,000 kilometers of fiber, and it has over 9,000 base station sites. So the point of discussion this evening is leadership and what is leadership. And I've often asked myself that question. What really is leadership? In my own opinion, leadership is the ability of an individual or a team to harness resources, particularly human resources, to willingly work together with superior performance to achieve a joint goal, vision, or objective. You can lead a group of people, but if you don't have superior performance to your competitors or your contemporaries, are you really a leader? Each leader has a unique style. And the one thing that you'll find in all leaders is all people who are real leaders is that they don't try to pretend to be someone that they're not. Some people have an autocratic style, some people are a lot more democratic, but you have to be yourself and work through your strengths and the true identity that you are. These are my ideas. I'm far from an expert. So a leader never tries to be anyone but himself or herself. Reading all the self-help books will not change your personality. Okay, you have to use your strengths that you have to achieve the goals that you want. But I think all leaders you'll see have courage. You will not find true leadership without a sense of courage. Courage to lead people to an unknown land, to have a vision out in the far distance of what can be achieved. I think very important is the courage to ask the difficult questions, both of yourself and of the team that you work with. I think the courage also to address the difficult discussions. So if you have a non-performing staff who isn't achieving what they should be, to actually sit down and tell them quite directly and frankly that you are not achieving what you should be in the organization that you work for. This is what you need to do. And if you don't do this, you will have to leave the organization. One of my subordinates who impressed me very much of recent within MTN Cameroon took a decision to terminate people who are not performing. And that's a rarity, even in senior management teams. So when you see someone who has the courage to take those decisions, which may seem sometimes heartless, but in reality, they're probably doing the person a favor to actually tell a person that you're not performing adequately, you need to leave this organization. It's a sense of a person who has the strength of a character to be a leader. Another attribute of leadership is clarity of purpose. People who don't have hidden agendas generally tend to get the credibility of their teams to move the business objective forward. So if I come into Cameroon as the CEO of Cameroon and I have an agenda of bringing 5,000 Nigerians to come and work in MTN Cameroon, immediately I've lost the credibility of the team in Cameroon. One of the messages that I've told my organization is that, look, in this organization, MTN Cameroon, the people who are going to progress in terms of career are going to be Cameroonians. And in every appointment that's been made since I've joined the organization, it has always been Cameroonians. 95% of the time, someone within MTN. So that gives a sense of credibility and makes very clear that my purpose and my objectives in the leadership of this organization are nothing but the performance of the organization itself. There's no hidden agendas. There's no hidden interest that I have. Every leader must have a passion for what they do. You cannot excel if you're in a field that you don't enjoy. And a passion means sometimes, I have woken up several times. Where's Felicity? I've woken up several times thinking about Felicity and Joel and about the performance of my organization. At 2 a.m. sometimes I wake up in the middle of the night and I'm wondering about aspects of the performance of my organization. So when they get a mail very early, it's not that I was that alert in early in the morning, but I thought of those issues in the middle of the night. But it wakes me up because I'm passionate about it. I care about it. I care about success. I care about the success of this organization very, very strongly. I think people who lead continuously strive and make a great effort to improve oneself. And towards the end of my little 10 minutes here, I'll give a little section on career development. You can never actually rest in the comfort that you know everything about your field and you have all the knowledge possible. If you're a leader and you aspire to be a leader, and I think I'm still aspiring to be a leader, you are continuously on a journey of self-improvement and self-learning. In terms of career development, I think it's good to change your industry, but you have to spend some time in your industry that you work in to really actually develop key competencies and stay there. Self-awareness is another key attribute of leadership. I think everybody needs to know what their weaknesses are. And once you know what your weaknesses are, you compensate for them by surrounding yourself with people who complement your strengths, okay, and help support you in your weaknesses. The ability to work with other people, to harness other people's experiences, cultures, and diversity is a key part of leadership, and particularly in the global world that we live in today. One thing that you find as a leader, and I promise you all of this, it's often said that it's lonely at the top, and that's true. If you're the CEO of a small, medium, very large company, you get all sorts of what I call noise continuously coming to you. This is what your subordinates are doing. This is what your competition is doing. This is what the government is planning. This is what you should do, etc. And one of the key attributes of leadership is to be able to just filter out 99% of that noise and pick up on the 1 or 2% that's valuable. Because a lot of it is noise, but you still have to listen all the same. Integrity is a key part of leadership. I think integrity means you never take a step that will work against your business. And credibility of what you say is what you do. And you're consistent in application of your policies is important. The question is often asked, are leaders born or are they made? But I think you cannot aspire to be a really top-level leader if you do not develop your abilities. Even if you have born abilities to lead, if you don't actively develop this, you won't go very far. Now, there are different types of leadership personalities and profiles, but sustained success in leadership usually comes with a very healthy dose of humility. And when I say humility, that means you don't have an overinflated opinion of yourself and you don't have a huge ego. Some of the most successful leaders in the corporate world today are people that you've heard very little about. There's a company called Kimberly-Clark. You see them, they make tissues, okay, that you use to wipe your hands and cleaning items. Now, the CEO of Kimberly-Clark was the CEO for about 15 years, and he delivered consistently superior performance over a stretch of 15 years, year after year after year. But he was never in the media. He was never looking for attention. And he was, when they asked him, what did you think about every morning leading this company? He said he would sit to himself and say, this board of directors are really stupid. How can they take someone as dumb as me to lead this organization? And that was his approach. He always felt he wasn't good enough for the job, and he had to work 2 or 3 or 4 times as hard, okay, to achieve the results. So these egoistical leaders who come and say, I know what to do, I have a vision, and I'm going to lead you down a path, they usually have good performance for 2, 3, 4 years, and then it disappears. You don't hear of them ever again. Another example of a leader that had extreme humility was a person who founded the most successful airline in the world, called Southwest Airlines. They revolutionized the airline industry. And in the middle of the night, he would leave his hotel room, and he would go and sit down with the crew working, okay, and actually carry baggage with the baggage handlers for Southwest. So in doing that, he got the buy-in of his staff. He understood the industry completely, and he kept that humility until he retired about 2 years ago. So humility for long-lasting success, and if you're not a person that's looking to boost your ego, is critical. Okay, I'm probably almost used up my 10 minutes. I want to take a mention of two things which I wanted to, or one issue around career development. Because I was expecting a younger crowd who would be interested in career development. I often get people who work with MTN approach me and say, MTN doesn't have a career mapped out for me, or doesn't have a career development planned out for me. I haven't seen myself being promoted in the last 4 years. I've been in the same position. I think it's important for everyone to recognize that no one can care about your career more than yourself. No company, no matter how good they are, General Electric, General Mills, Southwest Airlines, will create a career for you. You have to forge that for yourself. And no one can take the investment in your competencies and your career more seriously than you do. As part of my career development, I'm an engineer by training, but I used to be very intimidated by finance. All these strange things like return on equity and EBITDA and strange ratios that people would talk about I used to find slightly scary. But I decided I wanted to move out of being strictly an engineering function and towards a more business management career perspective. And so I took myself and I sponsored myself with my own holiday time and my own money on a corporate finance program in London Business School. I've done that for corporate finance. I've done that for strategic human resource management. I did it as well for a breakthrough program for senior executives in IMD in Switzerland. I did a course called Managing the Board of Directors with London Business School as well. I've also been fortunate to be sponsored in other areas by my organization, but I have invested in my own career myself very actively. And I've always taken one position. I will go and train myself on the area that I find most intimidating and most confusing. And that's how I've progressed my career through the years. So my most recent one was in business risk management, strategic risk. Every time my head of BRM will walk into my office, I'll say, oh God, this subject I don't know anything about. And so recently I went to Wharton Business School to educate myself on that. I'm a bit more comfortable. So from someone who is still on a very early part of my journey in leadership, those are a few ideas that I have. I think rather than just making this a one-way speech, I would love to interact with a few of you while I'm here on the podium. And if there's any discussion points or someone who wants to lecture me and correct me about any views that I have, I'll be more than welcome.
Je m'arrange pour toujours envoyer de l'argent à ma grand-mère, mais il y a tellement de tracasseries administratives. Ça, c'était avant que je souscrive au service MTN Mobile Money avec une pièce d'identité, puis de créditer son compte. Maintenant, je peux très facilement lui envoyer de l'argent. Je sélectionne simplement MTN Mobile Money, je compose son numéro et j'appuie sur « Envoi ». C'est aussi simple, bonjour. Souscrivez à MTN Mobile Money et envoyez votre argent en toute sécurité.
MTN, everywhere you go.
Mais mes parents, bon, ils m'avaient envoyé pour devenir un monsieur sérieux. Hein? Un avocat, un docteur, un ingénieur. Et qu'est-ce que je fais? La musique, c'est pas possible. Donc, on m'a coupé. Hein? Ils n'avaient plus d'argent, rien.
Quand les gens entendent Sol Makossa, ils disent que mon succès a été fulgurant. Mais vous savez, ce succès fulgurant m'a pris 24 années. 24 années de galère. 24 années à jouer. Et puis, un beau jour, boum, Sol Makossa. Quand on a une passion, il faut la poursuivre. Même si la route est longue. Ne renoncez jamais. Keep walking.
I'm Patricia Berthelot, working for Guinness. I do have a question for you, Carl. I just want to know, not in the capability side, you know, because you were talking in capabilities that you have make a lot of efforts to try to train yourself in finance and something like this. But I wanted to know what was the most difficult things you had to work, which belong to yourself, like a behavior or something, to become a greater leader.
My biggest problem is I'm extremely impatient. And that's driven by my passion.